What's going on, everyone? Talen here, and welcome to another Marvel Future Fight video. Alright, so for this video, I thought it'd be fun to test out Moon Knight here at level 70 and level 80, because I'm kind of curious to see how much level 80 is actually going to affect the characters. I've heard that it's actually a pretty good power bump, but I haven't gotten any characters level 80 in my account yet. I mean, we just have Moon Knight and Iron Man, and I didn't really feel like working on Iron Man because I'm kind of low on, well, I've already set that. What resource was I looking at? So we're at the level up part. The dimension debris and the lunch boxes, whatever, the essence. Yes, so I'm quite low on those, or I'm always low on those. So that's why I'm not really going to be leveling up characters unless I plan on doing something with them. And Moon Knight is a character that I'm thinking I'm probably going to get to tier 4 when I'm able to. So as soon as I get enough books, he's probably going to be my first one, but we'll see. But anyway, the point of this video is to see if there's going to be a big difference in terms of power for just getting from 70 to 80, you know, not tier 4 or anything like that, just the level difference. Is that going to be a noticeable difference? Because from 60 to 70 was definitely a noticeable difference in a lot of content. So let's see what we can get here. First of all, let's go over my build on Moon Knight. It's not very good. I mean, it's just a average build, but you know, we should be able to get a good comparison either way. So we do have some ruse on him. His skills, I never leveled up any of his skills. Oh, you can level him up more. I haven't even been paying attention to what's going on. That doesn't change anything to level 10. It just changes the physicalness. We don't get any more like all attack or anything like that. That'd be kind of cool though if you did more all attack and defense. The speed is the same, the crit's the same. So we just get more physical. Interesting. I don't know if that's really going to be worth it. But anyway, yeah, because I thought I had his skills leveled up. But anyway, there's his skills. We don't have an artifact on him. We have Hawk's Eye, and it's not fully awakened. We have a regular obelisk, just a 200% regular obelisk here, and I haven't worked on his uniform at all. So let's go ahead and get a base reading here for Moon Knight. And what we're going to do the testing is we're going to go over to Null, because that'll be a nice, easy way to do it. We'll do stage 9. We have this team here. We're going to stay with the same team both times. We will use 3 dodge ignore strikers to be kind of consistent here. And we're going to go for 1 minute. So we're going to see how much damage he can do in 1 minute's time. Right here at level 70, gears 20. And then we're going to pump him up to level 80 and see if we notice a big difference. So we're not going to be using his awakening skill because I don't want to have more RNG kind of thrown into it to make sure that I cancel it correctly and to make sure I do that efficiently or not. So we're just going to be doing his normal skill rotation for the whole minute. And of course, we're going to do the same thing once we get him to level 80 to be consistent here. So here we go. So far, so good. And I've done a few runs before to kind of get an idea where he's at. So we'll see if we're above or below the average here once we get to the 1 minute mark, which I think we might be doing a little bit better than my averages, because I think my damage track, oh, there, now it's not cooperating. I was actually cooperating there at the beginning. The other runs that I did, it was very delayed. Like, the damage proc was going off well into the fifth skill, so we're missing out on quite a bit of damage, I think. Alright, so like 49 bars, actually it's about what I saw before. We get to 49 to 48 bars is basically where I was at in my other test. So, we're consistent. So now, we're going to go ahead and get him to level 80 and try again. So let's get that process going here. And there we go. That should be level 80. Oh, new calling. Let's see what the challenge is. What do we get for a level 80 character? Ooh, get 80 crystals. All right, that's fine. I'll like me some crystals. I'll take those. So now, oh yeah, I wanted to see, what does it take to level up his gear? Okay, so carbonadium, and yeah, I have not been able to beat Dormammu for a giant boss raid, so I'm definitely not going to be getting these guys. So we're not going to be leveling up his gear. I was hoping I would be able to level up the gear. I just didn't know what resources it would cost. So yeah, it doesn't look like I'll be able to level up the gear, because I wanted to actually test level 70 versus level 80 versus level 80 with gears, what, 30, I guess it goes up to now. But looks like we're just going to have to settle for a level 70, level 80 comparison. So yeah, now he's level 80. So let's see what he can do against Null now and see if we get a big jump in power or not. All right, so we got the same team here and the same strikers. I'm going to be doing the same rotation. I'm not going to be using the awakening skill. And let's hopefully see a big improvement. I'd like to see a big improvement because that would be nice. But I don't know. Let's find out here. Okay, I'm definitely seeing more damage from that first rotation. Okay, yeah, the damage does seem to be... We got snared last time, so let's get snared again. Does seem to be significantly better, doesn't it? Come on, move. Proc, thank you. Oh my gosh, it looks like we might be doing almost twice as much damage. Interesting. We didn't even get to this part here last time, so I'll go ahead and avoid that. So we got like an extra 10 bars. Well, we'll get one more rotation in here. Okay, yeah, so we went from 49 to 35. That's pretty nice. So 14 more bars worth of damage. Not quite double the amount of damage, but whew, that is a lot. How many bars does he start with? Is that double the amount? Starts with 60? Starts with 60, right? Or am I imagining that? 59. Or... Let me make sure. Okay, yeah, it is 60. So, yeah. Big difference going from doing, what, 11 to 12 bars to doing almost, what, 25 bars? So, actually, we're doing more than double damage. Interesting. So, yeah, level 80 looks like it's a pretty substantial damage buff. So, that's actually pretty nice. So, I wonder what getting him to tier 4 would do. What are the extra stats that he gets? I wish I could preview it to see what kind of stat... Actually, you can preview, can't you? Let's see. So we got tier 2, Transcended. We want, where's the Awakening? Level 80, or can we not see? Oh no, that is tier 4. All right, so Transcended Potential. So 11.5 attack, 34 HP, and we go up to 16 and almost 50. That's a pretty big buff, pretty big bump. What did we do from this? That was just like 4,000. So it's a little more of a bump than when you transcend the character. Interesting. Wow, yeah, the tier 4 looks like it's gonna be really strong, which I would love to get Moon Knight there to tier 4, but like I said, I cannot get the resources as of yet. I still need to work on my account a little bit more before I could start taking on Dormammu. Since Dormammu was released, I have been doing a lot of changes to my account. I've been really, really working on getting my cards leveled up for their Pierce, so I've actually been working on them quite a bit, and I've pretty much doubled my Pierce since Dormammu came out. Because I only had 6% Pierce before, now I'm up to 11%, so I'm getting there, but 11% is still apparently not enough to take on Dormammu, and I'm guessing that's just because my other stats are too low. Like, I probably just need more all attack or something like that, but I don't know, we'll see. Maybe I'll get lucky and have a few other whale accounts help me out here. We'll see, but yeah, that's going to be it for this one. That was basically just a comparison for Moon Knight here. Let me know if... you've been getting both Moon Knight and Iron Man to level 80, if you've been happy with their upgrade and performance, because as you can see, I have a relatively low end build on Moon Knight. So, you know, if you had like an energy or a rage on either him or Iron Man and you got him to level 80, I'm curious to know, you know, how well they're performing for you. Are you seeing like a massive uptick in their damage? Are you able to push higher in stages they haven't been able to push before? Do they become I don't know, stronger than some of your other top characters that you have in your roster. But for me, I'm happy with the level 80 on Moon Knight. I'm thinking I'm probably going to upgrade him to a CTP because he might be one of my higher performers now in terms of my physical damage dealers. But yeah, that's going to be it for this video here. Hopefully you enjoyed, and of course I will catch you in the next one.